Hello student, today I am going to discuss part 1 of structural organization in animals. In this part we will discuss about the epithelial tissues. First we will discuss about the tissues. A tissue may be defined as a group of one or more types of physically linked cells having a similar origin and specialized for a specific function or functions. So tissue is a group of cells having similar origin, similar structure and similar function. Next is the term histology was coined by Mayer in 1819. A person who is specialized in the science of histology is called histologist. So one who is study histology, that person is called histologist. Next is the classification of animal tissue. As we know that there are three germ layers and different parts of the body are originated from these three germ layers. So these three germ layers are ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. So there are different classification of animal tissues. For example, they are classified into four major types: epithelial tissues, muscular tissues, connective tissues and nervous tissues. Epithelial tissues, they are originated from the ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm, and their main function is protection, secretion, absorption, excretion and reproduction. Actually they cover all the exposed part of body parts and they protect the underlying tissues from injury and damages. Second is secretion. They are modified to form the glands and they secrete different types of enzymes, hormones and other material. Absorption, for example in ileum or small intestine or in alimentary canal or in alveoli, there is absorption of gases takes place and exchange of material takes place. So their main function is absorption. Excretion, that they are found in nephron and helps in excretion of waste material. Some epithelial tissue, they are modified to form the germinal epithelium, and this germinal epithelium, they produce gametes. So epithelial tissues are also involved in reproduction. Next is the muscular tissues. They are originated and developed from the mesoderm, and function of muscular tissue, that they help in locomotion and movement. Next one is the connective tissues. They are also developed from mesoderm, and their function is attachment, support, protection, storage and transport. Last one is the nervous tissues, and they are originated from the ectoderm, and their function is control and coordination. First type of tissue is the epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue is composed of one or more layers of cell covering the external surface. They cover the external surface of the body. They also cover the viscera or internal organs and lining of cavities in the body and vice versa. Next is the general characteristics. It covers the external surface of the body and lines the internal surface of the hollow organs. ये दोनों ही surfaces को cover करता है, किसी भी organ के ये outer surface को भी cover करता है, and they also cover the internal surface of all the cavities. जितने भी hollow organs हैं उसको अंदर से भी cover करता है. The cells are arranged compactly with very little extracellular space. They are very compactly arranged. Here you also can see that these two cells, they are very compactly arranged. There is no intercellular space present here. So there is very little extracellular material, or they are arranged compactly. Epithelial cells rest on a non-cellular basement membrane which separate the epithelium from the underlying connective tissues. The basement membrane consists of two layers, outer thin basal lamina and inner thick fibrous lamina. So this is the structure of an epithelial tissue. Here you can find that these are the epithelial tissues. This upper part shown in pink color is the epithelial tissues. This one is the basal membrane, and third layer is the connective tissue. So there are three layers. The topmost is the epithelial tissues, second is the basement membrane, and third one is the connective tissue. So we will discuss about the first epithelium layer later on. But this layer of epithelial tissues, they lie on basement membrane. These basement membrane, they are of consist of two types of tissues. The outer is the thin basal lamina. This is the basal lamina, this one, and the inner is the thick fibrous or reticular lamina. This one is the fibrous or reticular lamina. Below this basement membrane, there is a layer of connective tissues. Connective tissues contains both nerves and blood vessels, because nerves and blood vessels are not present in epithelial tissues. So all the nutrients required by the epithelial tissues, they are provided by the blood vessels present in the connective tissue. Next is the classification of epithelial tissues. First is the simple squamous epithelium. Epithelium consists of thin, flat, disc-like cells. So this tissue consists of a very thin, flat and disc-like cells. They are polygonal shaped in surface view. Cells are closely fitted like the tiles in the floor. Nucleus is flat or lies at the center of the cell. This causes the cell to slightly bulge out. Here actually you can see that this is the, here the cells of squamous epithelium like this. So they are flat and nucleus is present in the center. Because they are flat and nucleus is present in the center, there is slight bulging. You can see here that slight bulging ka matlab hai, is nucleus ko ke andar present hone ki wajah se cells thoda sa ubre hue se hote hain. Cells thoda sa ubre hue hote hain and they are tightly fitted. तो यहाँ पर क्या क्या चीज़ें हमने डिस्कस की, ये सेल्स एपिथेलियल टिश्यू थिन फ्लैट और डिस्क लाइक सेल से बने हुए होते हैं. सरफेस व्यू में सामने से ये फ्लैट दिखाई दे रहे हैं, सामने से ये फ्लैट दिख रहे हैं, लेकिन सरफेस व्यू में अगर आप देखेंगे तो दे आर पॉलीगोनल इन शेप. दे आर पॉलीगोनल इन शेप. हियर यू कैन सी दैट फ्रॉम द टॉप व्यू अगर देखें आप, ये पॉलीगोनल दिखाई देते हैं, और अगर फ्रंट व्यू अगर आप देखेंगे तो ये फ्लैट सेल्स दिखाई देंगे. ब्लू कलर लेयर इज द कनेक्टिव टिश्यू एंड दिस ब्लैक कलर लेयर हियर, दिस ब्लैक कलर लेयर इज द बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन. सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड राइट नाउ दैट एपिथेलियल टिश्यू दे कंसिस्ट ऑफ थ्री लेयर्स. द अपर मोस्ट इज द एपिथेलियम. Below this is the basement membrane and the lowermost is the connective tissues which contain blood vessels and nerve cells. Next part is the location. This tissue forms the lining of the body cavity like mouth, nose, alveoli, blood vessels and blood vessels. Because they are very thin, so they are present at places where exchange of material takes place, mainly exchange of material takes place, absorption takes place, exchange of gases takes place. So they are present in the mouth, nose, alveoli and the blood vessel. Function, they protect the underlying tissues from the injury and drying out. So one important function of these squamous epithelial tissues is protection. Next is the exchange of material by diffusion across them. बहुत सारे material का जहाँ exchange होता है, जैसे alveoli के अंदर gaseous exchange होता है, elementary canal में, intestine में food absorb होता है, तो ऐसी जगहों पर ये squamous epithelium पाई जाती है, क्योंकि ये बहुत thin होती है. अगर इसको कोई भी layer thin होगी तो वहाँ पर exchange of material आसानी से हो जाएगा. So their main functions are protection, excretion and gaseous exchange. Next type is the cuboidal epithelium. Cells are equal height and equal width. They are of equal height and equal width. They are cube shaped. Here you can see that their width and height are somewhat equal. So they are like a cube. तो इसको हम देखें इस तरह से, तो ये एक क्यूब की तरह का सेल्स प्रेजेंट हो. ये भी फ्रंट व्यू में दे अपीयर्स एज क्यूब, बट फ्रॉम द टॉप व्यू अगर आप इसको ऊपर से देखें देन दे आर पॉलीगोनल इन शेप. दे आर पॉलीगोनल इन शेप. तो फ्रंट व्यू में दे अपीयर्स क्यूब शेप्ड एंड फ्रॉम द टॉप व्यू दे लुक लाइक हेक्सागोनल और पॉलीगोनल इन शेप. न्यूक्लियस इज round and present in the center of the cell. Here you can see that these are the nucleus. They are round and present in the center of the cells. Next is location. Cuboidal epithelium lines the kidney tubules, duct of salivary gland and thyroid gland. Also covers the ovaries, sperm producing tubules and fallopian tube या जितने भी vas deferens हैं, seminiferous tubules है, ये वहाँ पर पाई जाती हैं. And their function is protection, secretion, absorption and gamete formation. It means that they are modified to form the germinal epithelium and germinal epithelium further develops to form the gametes. They are also tightly fitted and very closely fitted. There is a, so first layer is the cuboidal epithelium. Below this, this layer is the basement membrane. Here this gray color layer is the basement membrane, and the lowermost layer is the connective tissues where blood vessels and nerves are present. Ek cheez yaad rakhiye, there is no blood vessels and nerves are present in these epithelial tissues. Epithelial tissues or basement membrane में कोई भी nerve cell या blood vessels present नहीं होती है. लेकिन इनको develop होने के लिए जो भी nutrient की ज़रूरत होती है, they are provided by the blood vessels present in the connective tissue. यहाँ पर blood vessels and nerve cell are present, and these blood vessels they provide all the nourishment to the developing or growing epithelial tissues. Next is the columnar epithelium. The cells are much longer, taller than wide. They are pillar like. Here you can see that cells are height of the cell is, this is the height and this is the width of the cells. So they appear pillar like or column shaped. That's why they are known as columnar epithelium. They are also from the surface view, they appears polygonal in shape. Nucleus is oval and present at the base of the cell. Free surface bear minute projections called microvilli. यहाँ पर कभी कभी इनके सरफेस पे छोटे छोटे स्ट्रक्चर्स प्रेजेंट होते हैं, हेयर लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स, एंड दे आर कॉल्ड माइक्रोविली. हेयर ऑल्सो दिस मेम्ब्रेन green color membrane is the basement membrane. Now the location, they form the lining of the stomach, reticulum, rectum, intestine, gallbladder, etc. It also forms the gastric gland, intestinal gland, etc. So they form the lining or a protective covering around the cavity of the stomach, rectum and intestine, gallbladder. They also form the gastric gland. These columnar cells, they modify to form the glands and they form the gastric gland as well as intestinal gland. The function, absorption, main function is absorption of nutrients in the stomach and intestine. They help in the protection and secretion. Next is the ciliated epithelium. Ciliated epithelium, it consists of columnar or cuboidal cells. They consist of columnar or cuboidal cells having numerous thin hair-like projections called cilia. Here you can see that there are some structures like this are present at the surface of these columnar cells. So these structures are called cilia, and such type of epithelial tissues are known as ciliated epithelium. Cilia arise from a minute basal granule lying below the membrane. So they develop from a basal granule. Here some basal granule is developed, and from these basal granule these cilia are originated or developed. Cilia show lashing action, move the mucus and other substances over the epithelium. They move like this. These cilia, they move like this. ये दोनों तरफ इस तरह से मूव करता है. इनके मूव करने की वजह से बहुत सारे मटेरियल जो इमोबाइल होते हैं, इमोटाइल होते हैं, दे मूव बिकॉज ऑफ द लैशिंग एक्शन ऑफ द सीलिएटेड एपिथीलियम. सीलिया मटेरियल को मूव करने में हेल्प करता है, क्योंकि सीलिया ये इसमें मूवमेंट पाई जाती है. जब ये सीलिया मूव करते हैं तो इनके मूवमेंट की वजह से बहुत सारा मटेरियल जैसे म्यूकस है या गैमेट्स है या ट्रैकिया में कोई अनवांटेड मटेरियल ट्रैकिया में प्रेजेंट है, तो इसको रिमूव करने के लिए सीलिया हेल्पफुल होते हैं. Location, they are found in trachea, windpipe, bronchi, sperm ducts and fallopian tube. जब भी trachea में कोई unwanted material अंदर जाता है, then they are pushed out by these cilia which are present in the trachea. Sperm ducts like epididymis, seminiferous tubule, vas deferens, यहाँ पर ये ciliated cuboidal epithelium present होते हैं और columnar epithelium present होते हैं, and they move the sperms towards the genital organ or towards the penis in male and fallopian tube in female. It functions in removing unwanted particle from the trachea. It helps in the movement of ovum and zygote towards the uterus. Next is pseudo-stratified epithelium. Pseudo-stratified, pseudo means false. This pseudo means false. And second thing is stratified. Stratified and non-stratified. Stratified का मतलब होता है कि multi-layered. Stratified का मतलब है layers, यानी बहुत सारी layers का. अगर epithelial tissues की कई layers पाई जाती हैं, जैसे squamous में देखा है, वहाँ पर single layer पाई जाती है. जहाँ पर बहुत सारी layer पाई जाती है उनको हम stratified कहते हैं. और इस तरह के epithelial tissues को हम स्ट्रेटिफाइड एपिथेलियल टिश्यूज कहेंगे। सीडो स्ट्रेटिफाइड का मतलब है कि दिस टाइप ऑफ एपिथेलियल टिश्यूज दे आर नॉट स्ट्रेटिफाइड दे बट दे अपीयर्स एज दे आर स्ट्रेटिफाइड। इनको देखने से ऐसा लगता है कि ये स्ट्रेटिफाइड होंगे। सो दिस एपिथेलियम इज वन सेल थिक बट अपीयर्स टू लेयर्ड बिकॉज ऑल द सेल्स डू नॉट रीच द फ्री सरफेस बट ऑल द सेल्स आर अटैच्ड टू द बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन। देखिए यहाँ पर अगर आप इन न्यूक्लियस की पोजीशन को देखें तो आपको ऐसा लगेगा कि यहाँ पर दो लेयर है सेल्स की, एक छोटे छोटे सेल्स की लेयर है और एक बड़े बड़े सेल्स की लेयर है, लेकिन एक्चुअली यहाँ पर एक ही लेयर है। क्योंकि अगर आप फर्स्ट सेल को देखेंगे तो ये भी बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन से अटैच है, अगर आप सेकेंड सेल को देखेंगे देन इट इज़ ऑल्सो अटैच टू द बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन, ये भी सेल बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन से अटैच है, थर्ड और फोर्थ सेल भी बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन से अटैच है। तो यहाँ जितने भी सेल्स हैं दे अपीयर्स एज मल्टी लेयर बट ऑल द सेल्स बिकॉज ऑल द सेल्स आर अटैच टू द बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन दैट्स वाई दे आर नॉट मल्टी लेयर बट दे अपीयर एज मल्टी लेयर दे लुक लाइक मल्टी लेयर एपिथीलियम दैट्स वाई दिस वर्ड इज यूज सीडो स्ट्रेटिफाइड। स्ट्रेटिफाइड का मतलब है लेयर्स, कि यहाँ पर एक फॉल्स लेयर हमें देखने से लगता है लेकिन वो होती नहीं है। होती क्यों नहीं है यहाँ पर देखिए, अगर दो लेयर मल्टी लेयर किस तरह की देखती है कि यहाँ पर कुछ सेल्स ऐसे हैं, सपोज ये स्क्वेमस एपिथेलियम हम बनाएं और अगर ये मल्टी लेयर्ड होती ये बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन नीचे यहाँ पे प्रेजेंट है, न्यूक्लियस आर प्रेजेंट, यहाँ आप देख सकते हैं ऑल द सेल्स ऑफ दिस लेयर आर अटैच्ड टू द बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन, ये बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन से सारी लेयर अटैच्ड हैं। अगर ये मल्टी लेयर्ड होती तो एक लेयर एपिथेलियल टिश्यूज की यहाँ होती, फिर इसके ऊपर हो सकता है एक लेयर और होती, तो इसको हम मल्टी लेयर्ड कह सकते हैं क्योंकि यहाँ पर सिर्फ नीचे वाली लेयर है जो इस बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन से अटैच है, ऊपर वाली लेयर दिस फर्स्ट लेयर एंड सेकेंड लेयर दे आर नॉट अटैच टू द बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन क्योंकि वो मल्टी लेयर्ड है। फर्स्ट लेयर थर्ड लेयर के ऊपर, सेकेंड सेकेंड के ऊपर फर्स्ट लेयर है, तो अगर सिर्फ एक ही लेयर बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन के कॉन्टैक्ट में है बाकी की लेयर्स नहीं है तो इसको हम स्ट्रेटिफाइड एपिथीलियम कह सकते हैं। तो दिस वन इज द स्ट्रेटिफाइड एपिथीलियम। But this one is not a stratified epithelium because all the cells are in contact with the basement membrane. सारे cells basement membrane के contact में हैं, इसलिए इसको pseudo stratified epithelium कहा जाता है। Here the tall cells have oval nuclei that lie at the different levels. The short cells have round nuclei and they are present almost in the center. Pseudostratified epithelium is of two types, pseudostratified columnar epithelium and pseudostratified ciliated epithelium. Ciliated columnar epithelium. Pseudostratified columnar epithelium and ciliated columnar epithelium में सिर्फ यही है, ये जो आप स्ट्रक्चर देख रहे हैं ये इसी का एग्जाम्पल है columnar epithelium का। सीलिएटेड एपिथीलियम में बस इनके सरफेस पर कुछ सीलिया डेवलप हो जाएंगे, अगर इनके सरफेस पे सीलिया डेवलप हो रहे हैं तो इसको हम सीडो स्ट्रेटिफाइड सीलिएटेड कॉलमनर एपिथीलियम कहेंगे।